everyone, welcome back to Pokémon Master EX. We are here for another villain arc, this time for Unova. And you guys voted a lot in the poll that I made on the YouTube channel. Actually, let me check out the results at this exact moment, because it is a very interesting arc with how popular the original Getis and N event was in the channel, so I'm very excited to see what will happen in this story. So the poll where I told you which character do you want? Hilda, Hilbert, a possible N alt, or are you going to skip? The winner is clearly Hilda with 51%, followed by Skipping with 24%, probably a lot of Alola fans since Alola is getting really ignored by the game this year for reasons to me unknown, but we still don't have an alt for Selene and Helio, which is really a shame. Followed by a possible N alt with 13% and last Hilbert with a 12%. Of course, it is a small pool of people, but still, I'm glad to see that you guys are going after my choice as well, because indeed we are here today to roll for Signasuit, Hilda and Victini. It is a fire-type sync pair, so not something that I strictly need, since we already rolled actually for a Signasuit villain arc sync pair with Mei and Blaziken back 3 months, 4 months ago, so actually this is sort of a repeat. But you guys know, I like Hilda, I like Rosa, I like Mei, so it is a no-brainer that I will go for this sync pair. How many sync move levels? Well, let's start by getting one, then we see if we actually get a good first 3 pulls, let's say, then I might go in and try to get a total of 5 so that I can use a candy then. I saw that there is actually quite a crazy deal for €3.50, that you can get 3000 paid gems plus a candy, which is actually not too bad, because then I would also roll for paid banners, which are a lot better than standard ones, especially if there's going to be something crazy like the Isui characters coming in really soon. But I'm not really sure if I want to become a Delphin, as they like to call it, or actually a Minnow in this case, because €3.50 for 1 month of stuff, that's like 2 coffees, so 2 days worth of my morning, so not actually a lot. Anyway, let's get into it. Let's go for this Gacha. It is a Poképhere, so the best deal in general to roll for a character. Master Sync Pairs, by the looks of it, we are safe for now. We are not going to have a repeat of what happened during the anniversary with Giratina and Cynthia, etc., because that was one terrible time to roll. I hate that type of Gacha so much, but it always has some of my favorites, so I have sort of comply with what it offers. Poképhere instead is usually a very good one to challenge, because as you can see, you always get 5 stars, it always has a good chance of giving you the one right up, and in general, it never disappoints from the ones that we've did in the past. So very excited to see how many gems it will take for us to get, not Mei, Hilda. I keep confusing her with Mei because the bot received a Signasuit with a fire type, and the bot very good. Immediately, Hilda brings in a whole new level of offensive power into the Fire teams, but Fire is actually so crowded that I don't even think she was necessary. Still, I do like the sync pair design, I do like how it works and flows very well with Anniversary N, which I also have, and also Signasuit Morte, which I don't have, but if he gets a rerun, I might think about it just to get a very cool Fire type team. Anyway, we are at 33, so far not so lucky, a shame because I actually hoped that the streak of luck with the Poképhere will continue. It was the only Gacha where I didn't have to pull my hair because it went so bad. By the looks of it, okay, let's not speak because we have a 5 star here. Come on, Hilda, you can do it. Show me the sign of victory with the fingers. Ok, not Hilda, this is Rock Olivia, ok. One other character from Alola who has never. Ok, there we go, that's my Hilda. Bam! There it is, my friends. Indeed, the sign of victory, Victini and Hilda are here. Very, very happy about this, for sure. Now, I actually went over what I would say was enough for me to chase a total of 5, so I won't risk it because I might want to get the N alt if I can or the Hilbert alt. I haven't decided yet. I'm more torn by the fact that they sort of teased something for December, and if I don't remember wrong, Legends Arceus released back in January. So if they do the 1 year rule, then between December and January, we should start seeing some of the Isui characters. I am one of those people that really enjoyed Legends Arceus, so I would love to get the character from there. So for now, I will hold off here. Maybe do another pull. Like 15,000 is not bad to roll for a possible and a halt, hoping that it's not a Master Fair, of course, otherwise it is bad. Let's just do one more. One more, so I can leave you guys with a satisfying conclusion. At least we can check out if I get a dual of five, which will be amazing, since we get an ultra-powered Hilda. So, one other thing that I have to say, of course, since it is a part of what's been going on with PokéFairs, she has extra tiles for level 4 and 5 of her sync move, which is bad for multiple reasons, but still, if you are someone going after the most possible power for your sync pairs, take that in mind. We have an Hidan, very cool. Very cool, not cool. Ghoul are the monsters that came from the dead, but I'm recording this on Halloween, so maybe it is the festivity taking its toll on me. Okay, so there we go, that's a satisfying conclusion indeed. We got Iris, we got Hilda, a very Unovan set of showcases that we had recently at least. I had actually a lot of them, so let me go to the upgrade and check out my EX characters after we upgrade Hilda, of course. So increase potential. This is filtered because I was checking for last week Champion Stadium if I could record some gameplay, but I actually said let me just wait to get the new characters in case I need the tickets. And there we go. So, as usual, when you power up, do the ones that you get for free first, and then do the ones that you have from your standard rolling, etc. Let's go max upgrade and let's unlock the EX right now. I love this new upgrade panel since it makes things so easier. Let's see her alternate costume. Actually, I think that it is very cool and it is actually what I will call an alternate costume. Because as you can see, the color actually changes. Very, very cool. Now, if you ask me which one is better, I prefer the azure look a little bit more, because the other one doesn't really make her stand out from her other hats. This one instead, it does, in my opinion, so I would love to keep this one if I can. For some other ones like Iris, I prefer the original one, Lily, I prefer the original one, but I kinda like to keep them in EX in general, because I do think that it has its own charm to keep the alternate costume. It is a sign that you really like the character, in my opinion. Ok, so let's go into move level, maybe this is the best one, and let's filter by EX. Ok, no, not initial number, there is no character that started as an EX. So, first Hilda, we have done it. Courtney, I've recorded it, just need to release it whenever it will be. Skyla, we've done it. Gloria, Marnie and Leon, we've done it. Me, we've done it. Nessa, we've done it. That Marnie, I think we did Summer Marnie. Bea, it's another one that I'm planning to do. Ok, so we have Bea, Anne, Sonia, Steven and the new Hilda. Probably the new Hilda will come first. Then I will probably try and do Anniversary Anne and the new Anne whenever it comes. And then we will resume the backlog, so do Sonia and Steven. Then there are a lot more that we already done, like Groudon. Phoebe have not done it, but because we have a standard showcase already, so wasn't really that worth it. Chris, I do think that actually have a standard showcase for Chris as well. Ok. So at some point I will start doing votes for whichever character you guys want to see next for the showcases, because I'm kinda getting to the point where I've kinda upgraded everyone that I care about. The ones left are, for example, the standard Sonia, Erika over here, Lana, probably Guzma, I would love to do it, but I don't think that the standard one is very good, to be honest. The normal N, Red, probably down the line I will have to do it, but it's one out of five, kinda is saddening. And Dianta, those are some other ones that I have in mind, but we'll see. Anyway, for today this is it. Thank you much for watching, my friends. Hopefully, if you're going after Hilda or Hilbert, you will get them, whichever one you prefer, but most of you are going after Hilda. For me, this is it for the gacha, at least until part 2, whenever that is. I heard that it is this month as well, so it is a villain arc that concludes in the same month. For the story of the villain arc, I'm not really sure when during this week I will release it, but not worry, because this week is very busy. We have the new Genshin patch, we have the new pre-gon event, we have a ton of stuff that I have to go through, so, and also have to end the Fate Halloween, not really Halloween, but the Fate event, so there is a ton of stuff going on, but not worry, I will get the villain arc into the channel by the end of the week at the latest. But for today, this has been it, thank you much for watching, remember to like and a sub if you want to support the channel, and if you want to support the channel even more, you can always use the Super Thanks feature to leave a comment with a donation of your choosing below your favorite Pokémon Master EX video. This has been Hunter Lodge with another victorious gacha in name of Victini, and for today, this is it. Bye my friends, and enjoy the new villain arc.